Great, thank you very much. So yes, my name is Mikey Please. I'm one half of Parabella. We're an animation directing duo repped by Blink Inc. in London. And we were tasked with the job of cushioning the public between the transition from the warm, cozy bosom of the BBC into the edgy commercial talons of Channel 4, the most loved show on British telly. So, so we did this massive, big baking extravaganza. Here's a little poster. And when we first got the job, we didn't get, they didn't kind of give it to us. We had to pitch over months. My girlfriend was like, you know how, like, what a hot potato that is. Like, you're going to get a lot of stuff from people. People are really angry. Like, she was really angry about it. And I was like, nah, it's fine. We're going to do, like, baking cakes. Everyone's going to love it. What could possibly go wrong? And just the process of making it was, in itself, an enormous challenge. But nothing would prepare me for what came next. So I'm just going to start off just by showing it, so you can all kind of watch it in its beautiful, positive light, and then talk a little bit about the stuff that happened afterwards. Okay, so here it is. Oh, I have to press it again.
Set your egg timers. The Great British Bake Off is back. Coming soon on Channel 4.
All right. So here I am smugly dusting off after a job well done. it was a very, very messy production, and I got very dirty. A couple of weeks later, I mean, it was a really quick turnaround once we were actually making the thing. I was sitting down, like, nice and relaxed, feeding my son some mashed potato, and it was about lunchtime, and I was like, oh, it came out at 12. I wonder how it's gone down, because it'd been nothing but like a wonderful, positive experience. Like, everyone, we made the lady who owned the house that it's filmed in. She cried when she saw it. She was like, my little show. Ah, oh, it's just like a wonderful, wonderful, like, warm feeling all around. So I was like, oh, this is going to be great. Everyone's going to love it. And it was trending on Twitter. not in a good way. And then you know when you Google news stories and all the headlines pop up along the thing? Creepy and fans divided and lash out. First creepy look. And then this is my favorite. I mean, the mass hysteria. Mass hysteria. So you can imagine, like, you know, the sort of potato sliding off the spoon and my face going wide and be like, oh God, like, I'm never, ever gonna work again. This is the end. Spoiler alert, it's fine. It was all fine. Everything kind of turned out okay. But not as bad as Prue Leith's spoiler, eh? Don't know if anyone, she let loose who won the bake-off earlier. I'm gonna flash slide that later, but it'll just be so quick. Who won? You won't even notice. No, I'm not gonna do that. That'd be horrible. So, straight to my first, it's like Willy Wonka's Factory, If It Was in Hell, which I only just noticed today. She's got a blue tick, which means she's an authoritative voice. Anyway, she had it absolutely spot on. We did start thinking, this is a page from our treatment. Willy Wonka in hell. No, we started in some very, very strange places. All we really knew was that we wanted to make a bakemation, and we just were, with the team at Full Creative, kind of looking for that thing that is that kind of encapsulates the spirit of Britain and baking. And obviously, these wicked photo montages weren't quite hitting it. Another thing. So, and we were conscious of, like, well, we don't want to, like, upset people. this is a great one. And eventually we got to this beautiful idea. This is a drawing by Bryony Mae Smith, which I look back on now. We kind of dismissed it in the, we didn't make it into the final ad, but I look at this now and I think, yes, that's it. That's the thing we were trying to do, which is about things coming together, be they ingredients or people, and what comes out of it is something greater. something greater than the sum of its parts. And that is kind of, what baking is, and the act of baking, bringing people together. And I just think that really sums it up. I absolutely love that drawing. So once we'd kind of got that spine to our film, we started getting our hands dirty kind of as soon as we could. It took us a long time to, like, find that track and figure out the structure. Me and my brother wrote some songs. We, like, recorded them really awfully. We did loads of stuff, but I won't tell you about those. We baked lots of stuff. In case you're unfamiliar with our other work, we're not food specialists. Like, this isn't what we do. we're just kind of character animators, but we were tasked with making this thing that was completely out of edible stuff. So we were like, okay, great. Well, that's, like, one thing you're really not meant to do. It's like working with animals and children. If you're in live action filming, you don't work with stuff that's gonna, like, rot or get eaten by mice. Or fall apart, all the stuff that happened. And don't animate through flour, which is what...
Why are we here? What's life all about? Is God really real? Or is there some doubt?
Okay, so it's all done for real, which clearly went past Kino Picta. Not amused by good content. It was absolutely loads of R&D, like, just messing about with stuff. Quite a few of the ideas that finally, don't need audio on that really, quite a few of the ideas that actually made onto screen were, like, we had put stuff in our animatic that just wasn't really possible. So we were figuring out things on set as well, so all these, like, great, great fun testing things, which is, like, part of the joy of stop motion animation and doing things for real, is that every shot in this was a little challenge. Again, things we'd sort of just put in the animatic because it was, like, a nice idea that symbolized two things coming together and being a bit more positive at the end of it, were actually really frustratingly hard to do. So, and this is one of the early tests of, like, the buttocks rising. It didn't really work. So we ended up doing, like, hundreds. Hundreds of these things, and we found that interesting little fact that if you put different degrees of yeast spread out throughout the thing, the buttocks rise in this, like, really sort of beautiful way that staggers off. But there were a lot of poor baked people that fell by the wayside. This is the test reel. So this is basically it, minus. Oh, you don't need to hear the song again. Minus the good stuff. So yeah, oh, this had to go, that shot had to go by the standards division of Channel 4 because it was too pornographic, which is fair, but it made it through. It's really sweet. So everything was a little challenge. Each shot was just like another task, another, like, problem, a big myriad of problems. Is there a good one coming up? Which just took a lot of figuring out. So one of the worst problems, and one of the ideas that we felt like symbolized this thing so well, were the croissants holding hands. And we're just like, yes, like that is it. Like that was the first one we got, and we're like, that's what we're trying to do. But it turns out getting croissants to touch hands is really hard. So what we ended up doing was building this like incredibly complex rig where we'd wired all the, nah, that's a lie. I actually just did that just for tonight. We didn't do that. It turns out if you turn croissants upside down, they do it naturally. So they're meant to do that. And so, but that took us probably thousands of pounds worth of experimenting to figure that out. Again, wonderful dough experiments. This is my sort of my favorite test reel. The preferred test obviously didn't make it in. This is sort of what was in the animatic. And it looked, it's a nice idea, but in reality it's rubbish. So we just sort of played around with all these great fun tests. I kind of wish the film was just this, to be honest. I feel like we wouldn't have got trolled so hard if it was just that. Let it play out. It's a really nice one at the end. Yeah. Oh yeah. So what we ended up doing is basically a mixture between the two. These two rising, kind of old lady things. We weren't allowed to do that, which is a shame. So again, now I want to vomit. So Drew Fence, well, that's exactly what we wanted to do too. There's actually four vomit shots in the ad, because we felt, well, this was one of the justifications in the meeting for this, was that baking doesn't always go right, like real life, you know, things fall apart, and mistakes are just as much part of the process as the successes. So these are little, I might not go all the way through this. I'm over time already. So anyway, it was actually really hard to get things to puke on cue. So hence the introduction of the haunted animator, which was an absolute dream to get those guys to puke. The only instruction on the box, and I'm not kidding, apart from the word like animator on it, was this. That's all it came with. That was the only thing on the box. Poor cock muffler's now going to have nightmares for weeks. Which segues quite neatly into mine and my brother's favourite pastimes at Christmas is decorating my mum's cake, despite her protests. So this didn't make it into the pitch document, but I did show the creatives later as just like another direction that we could go in. But they're not cool with it. So apparently the actual stuff of nightmares, according to Jen. But she's wrong. It's the stuff of dreams. It was such a dream project. I really kind of restored my faith in a lot of kind of working in advertising. Had just a really wonderful time doing it. So, you know, we got to make this giant kind of totem to Britain and all its sort of wonderful diversity and try to make it a big kind of celebration of British culture, you know, with a myriad of beautiful baked things that had all come together, tromping up this giant lolling tongue to a monstrous demonic cake at the top, which eats them, but that's a small detail. So yeah, we had about 2 weeks to make this entire thing. Again, we had gone through a lot of stuff before, so we'd kind of broke it all down into little bits. All edible, completely edible, maybe a bit salty, but technically edible. Fancy baking techniques, the lion. Got slated for using the lion, but we thought it was a nice thing. So this was our sort of incredible thing that we managed to do in a couple of weeks. All the meringues, real meringues, well, at least they were. That's the one, see, they're actually not real meringues. me and my girlfriend kind of cooked them over one weekend, and then on set they all sort of melted and dribbled off the wire, so we had to pretend in the end. And I'll just show a quick brief making of. It's about a minute and a half long. This is my favorite one. So back to that morning when I just like was like, oh, this is gonna be so great. You know, usually animation feedback is like, man, I love the water effects. But that day was obviously very different. And I called up the creatives of Channel 4 and was like, is this the end, you know? And they're like, nah, don't worry about it, mate. No, it's brilliant. It's the best thing that's ever happened. Can't believe it. You know, they were obviously thrilled. They knew it was happening. No one had just sort of told me, expect some pain, apart from my girlfriend who had warned me at the beginning, but I hadn't really listened. Really, really wonderful, wonderful project. Sad face to happy faces, there we go. And we can now kind of draw the evening to an end just by flipping the projector onto the Bake Off final and just kind of watching it together as one, one big happy family. No, that's it really. Thank you very much. Cheers.